Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on how to add basically SwiftUI in UIKit, well, kind of, with the help of DuckUI. And in today's video, I will show you the basic hello world setup in DuckUI. So let's jump right into the code. Okay, in the previous episode, we have just simply installed the DuckUI and have taken a look at the view controller and why you should basically use it. You could use UI view controller if you wanted to, but this is much more simpler. Just a reminder, setup views with safe area, observe, bond, and fetch data are added to our view did load. So let's just jump into definition. As you can see, we are just simply in the view did load, setting our background to white and calling all of these functions. And of course, in the setup views, we are adding a container that we can use easily. So yeah, basically that is adjusted. You could use it or you could not, but I highly recommend it because it's a real nice shortcut. So let's delete this container's background color because I want to set it back to white. That is real nice. And when you first launch a SwiftUI project, you can see that there is a text there with the text. So it's kind of labeled there with the text saying hello world. So today we are going to create or replicate rather all of that with DuckUI, and we are going to print out there or add there as a label hello DuckUI. So it is pretty straightforward to do this, and we will just use it create it with a simple vertical stack. Yeah, and this is just an intro to vertical stack. It's not the point. We are going to talk about stacks in a later video. So what you need to do is in the setup views with safe area or in the view did load, if you are not using a DView controller, just select your view or your container in our case. And I will just go with the DView controller for now on. Okay, so container dot and D underscore. And as you can see here, we have some variations of stack, vertical stack, horizontal stack. And we are just going to use the plain old vertical stack without spacing alignment or distribution. I will talk about that in later videos. So let's just add that in there. And we have created a stack as one would add in SwiftUI. So what we want to add in here is a label. Now we could create the labels in the setup views with safe area or in the view did load, but we want to access those elements in the stack. So we are going to add in here our views so we can modify them, access later. So we are going to create our hello DuckUI label here, and for brevity we are just going to create a simple UI label. Okay, and I will create a lazy var variable because I want to set the text right here. We could do that let me just show you how we can do that with a DuckUI. Okay, so hello DuckUI label, there we go. And let's scroll down to our stack and just add in here hello DuckUI label. Believe it or not, that is all to it. Now we need to, of course, add some text. So with the dot notation and chainable methods or functions inside DuckUI, and of course they are in SwiftUI too, you can easily add this here. So let's add in here some text. So dot text, and make sure you select the one that is returning a UI label because you maybe want to chain add more methods there. So there we go, UI label text, and I would just add in here hello DuckUI. Okay, now that is kind of basic, but it will not, let's just build and run. Maybe we will not see anything because, or maybe we will, but it will not be basically in the center. So what we want to do is because we have our stack, let's just set the text alignment. And there we go, text alignment and center. Let's see if this kind of fixed it. And maybe it did, maybe it didn't. There we go, it did. Now, I told you that maybe it did, maybe it didn't. And if you hover or just you are on the same line in Xcode 11, you can see on the preview page, not on the simulator, of course, that this is highlighted where the bounds of the label are highlighted. So let's add that functionality here too. So dot debug. Okay, and yeah, that will draw a debug view on the Hello DuckUI label. And because we are having all of this stretched out to the vertical stack, as you can see, this is all of our label. So that is to it. Here we have our text alignment and some debug if we wanted to. So let's remove all of this and maybe add this dot notation down here, or rather yet, let's just use the second one only. And yeah, basically that is it. The Hello DuckUI label on a vertical stack. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions about DuckUI and why I would recommend it, to basically learn it, to have it transition, your transition be very easy to SwiftUI, go ahead and comment down below. I'm really interested in what you think about DuckUI, and I'm really interested in your questions. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.